Silk reeling. Silk reeling is a process by which a number of cocoon babes are reeled together to produce a single thread. This is achieved by unwinding filaments collectively from a group of cocooned cocoons at one end in a warm water bath and winding the resultant thread onto a fast moving reel. Raw silk reeling may be classified by direct reeling method on a standard sized reel, indirect method of reeling on a small reels, and the transfer of reeled silk from small reels to onto standard sized reels on a re-reeling machine. The last technique is primarily applied in modern silk reeling processes. In India, there are three distinct reeling devices in mulberry sector, namely Charaka, a crude system of reeling comprising of about 35,000 units whose production contribution is about 50% of the total silk production. Second, cottage basin, system improved over Charaka comprising of about 20,000 units whose production contribution is about 40% of the total silk production, and multi-end reeling basin system supposed to be the modern version in India comprising of about 4,000 installed basins. Of these, about 3,000 are active and their production contribution is about 5% of the total silk production. Dupian silk production is about 5%. Various silk reeling devices. There are many types of silk reeling devices in use. The major structural features of the sitting type reeling machine, the multi-ends reeling machine, and the automatic reeling machine. Charaka type of reeling machine. The Charaka type is in use in India. This machine is operated with separate work motions in reel driving and cocoon feeding to reeling ends by two men per machine. Each machine has three ends or more to reel, which is the same size as the large wheel of the re-reeling machine in order to save the re-reeling process. The main reason why Charaka is still dominating in India silk reeling industry is that bulk of raw silk production is used in the handloom industry, wherein the cost factor of the raw material has to be kept low to enable the rate of the finished products saleable. Secondly, the establishment of Charaka unit does not need any big investment or special skill. This enables Charaka silk to be sold at a minimum price, which is very much wanted by the handloom industry. Thirdly, inferior quality multi-voltine and defective cocoons available at lower prices can be reeled more economically on Charaka than on cottage basin or multi-end basins. Multi-ends reeling machine. This reeling device is a further improved version over the cottage basin and it is power driven. Boilers are installed and steam is used for cooking and reeling purpose and also for cocoon stifling in the special steam chambers. Since recently, hot air drying methods are being introduced for bivoltine cocoons in some of the filature units in the country for improving the working efficiency and quality of reeled silk. This machine eliminates the disadvantages of the sitting type reeling machine by increasing the number of reeling threads, ends per basin, and reducing the reeling speed. The operator must stand when running this machine as the number of reeling threads per basin increases by 20-fold. This is also called as standing type reeling machine. Normally, cocoon cooking is done according to a single pan system as in the case of cottage basin. Three pan cooking system evolved by the institute wherein the cocoons are subjected to varying temperatures associated with hot air stifling has been found to be suitable for biotin cocoons on multi-end basin, and it is followed in a few villages in the country. Cocoons taken in a wire meshed cage are subjected to lower temperature at 65 plus or minus 5 degrees centigrade in the first basin for about 1 minute, and then they are subjected to higher temperature at 95 plus or minus 3 degrees centigrade in the second basin for about 1.5 minutes. And thirdly, these cooked cocoons are subjected to lower temperature at 65 plus or minus 5 degrees centigrade in the third basin for about a minute. Later, the cooked cocoons are hand brushed at boiling point. The multi-end reeling machine is composed of driving part, grouping ends, picking ends, standby path, reeling part, jet about, stop motion, traverse guider, small reels, steam heating pipes and clutches. In multi-end basins, there are some additional attachments such as jet about, which picks up the filament to increase the efficiency of cocoon feeding. The distribution system is further improved and individual break motion for each reel is also provided, so that the overall working efficiency of the basin enhances. Normally, each basin consists of 10 ends. Basin. The basin is rectangular with well rounded corners and edges. It is only 10 to 12 centimeter deep. It is commonly made of dark colored porcelain. The basin is subdivided into sections, each intended for a specific job, such as brushing, end gathering of babes, stalks in reserve and waste collection. Reels. The reels of the multi-end reeling machine have a circumference of 75 centimeter. The frame of the reel is made of light metal or plastic. The reels are fitted into a reel carrier and driven by a transmission shaft by connecting gears. Traverse guider. To ensure narrow and long web on the hank of the reel, a cam type traverse assembly has been fixed. This will make a convex surface in the hank, which is wound on the reel. The center part of the hank is higher than the two axes. Thread button. Porcelain button thread guiders are used for removing any dirty adhering to the thread passing through the tiny aperture in the button. Automatic reeling machine. Automatic reeling machine is the improved version over the multi-end reeling machine designed and extensively used in Japan for reeling univoltine and biotine cocoons. The automatic reeling system is a Japanese version or Sunken system, which is suitable for better quality cocoons in producing quality raw silk. Automation for reeling was introduced in Japan in 1950s in order to improve the quality of the old time hybrid cocoons and to increase the efficiency of the reeling. With the introduction of the automatic reeling machines, the productivity of the raw silk yarn per basin has increased remarkably. Besides, improvement in the quality of raw silk. By 1965, most of the silk reeling mills in Japan had switched over to automatic reeling machines, and Japan emerged as a leading exporter of high quality raw silk yarn to Western countries. The automatic reeling machine mechanizes the processes of grouping ends, picking ends, cocoon feeding to reeling thread, and separation of dropped end cocoons during the reeling process. The efficiency of the automatic reeling machine compares favorably with the manual multi-ends reeling machine. In automatic reeling machine, the collective cocoon filaments are initially drawn through jet about, slub catcher or button onto the top crozier pulley, guide pulley, indicator device, lower crozier pulley, crozier, guide pulley, tension pulley, brake lever, and finally onto the reel through the ring attached to the traverse bar. The automatic reeling machine, though built to replace manual reeling, still requires manpower for problems with the reeling thread, which must be corrected by hand. A moderate amount of cuckooed cocoons are carried to the newly cuckooed cocoon feeder and then removed into the grouping end pot. The end grouped cocoons go to the picking end pot, and the correctly picked end cocoons are dispensed to the cocoon supplying basket, which continuously rotates around the reeling basin on an endless chain belt. Usually, the reeling method is classified into fixed cocoon feeding system and moving cocoon feeding system. Generally, one set of the automatic reeling machines has 400 ends, while one basin has 20 ends. The operating efficiency of the automatic reeling machine is easily affected by cocoon qualities. The main parts of the automatic reeling machine and the operations are described in the following paragraph. Grouping pot. Freshly cuckooed cocoons and dropped cocoons are brushed in this pot, and the cocoons with filament ends are collected and transferred to the cocoon feeding pot. The grouping pot consists of grouping tubs at both ends of the reeling machine and grouping equipment. The brushing device operates mechanically to pick the filament ends from the cocoon surface. The grouping tub receives freshly cuckooed cocoons from the cocoon boiling machine through conveyors and also dropped cocoons from the pupae separating apparatus. The tub is connected with water and steam pipes, and the temperature of water in the tub is maintained at about 80 degrees centigrade. A thermostat and solenoid valve on the steam pipe maintains the temperature of the brushing water at a constant level. Cocoon supply pot. This is a device to supply the cocoons to the reeling pot based on the requirement of the cocoons at the reeling end, which is sensed by the denier detecting mechanism. The cocoon supply mechanism can be classified into two types. One, cocoon feeding from a standing bath, and cocoon supply from the conveyor buckets. Cocoon feed from the standing bath. It is a device consists of a chain of small receptacles, means buckets, which are moving around the machine. As these receptacles or buckets reach the grouping pot, the brushed cocoon from the feeding pot transfers a small quantity of cocoons into the buckets. The filament end is drawn over the heated wire and cut off. The buckets on their way around the reeling machine drop the cocoons into the reeling berth. Second one, the moving system of cocoon supply. Cocoons are fed to the reeling end from the conveyor bucket itself. The buckets with the cocoons received from the supply pot moves around the machine, and based on the signals from the denier indicator, the cocoon picking lever lifts a cocoon from the bucket directly to the reeling end. Cocoon filament end feeding apparatus. The function of this part is to add a single filament end to the group of filaments being reeled. As and when the denier of the yarn is reduced due to the filament breakage or the cocoon is exhausted, the operation of feeding is in coordination with the operation of the denier sensor. In a standing bath type of machine, this part consists of a place of stocking cocoons with filament ends and a small passage for every reeling end, in front of the reeling both, which serve as a gate. The size of the gate is such that only one cocoon can fit in the place. A vibrating place is provided to cause turbulence in the water, such that the cocoons are pushed towards the gates. Cocoons with filament ends are dropped into this part by the moving buckets and wait in this part until they are fed to the reeling bath. The filament ends are tied onto a binding rod and are pushed towards the gate due to the action of the vibrating flap. The cocoon filament, which is bound to the binding rod, is gathered by the jet about, and filament is joined to the reeling end whenever the picking lever strikes the picking fork. Reeling part. The filaments passing through the jet about tube passes through the button and over the crozier pulleys to form a tablet crozier, and then passes through the denier sensor. The denier sensor is a device which detects the denier of the yarn being reeled before it is wound onto the reel. Two types of sensors have been developed. One is the constant number of cocoon type, and the other one is constant denier type. The constant denier type is more common. Denier sensor. A device consists of two glass plates with the inner surface highly polished, a central brass axle, a polyester film placed in between the glass plates, a detecting pin fixed on one side of the glass plate and to the washer on the other side. A balancing weight is placed next to the detecting pin, and the whole assembly is tightened in its place with a lock, nut screwed to the axle. The different parts of a denier sensor used in Kiernan automatic reeling machine. The yarn after the crozier passes in between the glass plates, which are separated by the polyester film. The size of the gap between the glass plates is about the diameter of the yarn being reeled. The sensor is mounted in the position where the yarn has an upward path before it is wound onto the reel. Brushing and picking section. An automatic 10 brush unit brushes cocoons with independent arms rotating in reverse motion on an axis in a circular basin. Picking frames rotating in one direction pick off the brushed cocoons filaments when a cam during the operation raises the brushes. Selective picking is completed in the most effective manner by this equipment. To maintain the exact number of cocoons at each reeling end, a control device is attached which detects the amount of cocoons in the cocoon suppliers and automatically supplements deficiencies in the number of cocoons. Reeling section. The denier indicating and detecting device. In these devices, the yarn constantly passes through the denier indicator and detector, which are set to a given size. The size of the thread being reeled is detected through the balance between the friction of the running thread and an eccentric weight fitted on the denier indicator. Conveyor system for cocoon suppliers. The fixed end feeding system is employed together with the conveyor system to carry cocoon supplies and feeds cocoons to the reeling section whenever required. End feeding for cocoon suppliers. Cocoons are supplied to the conveyor, which rotates constantly around the reeling section. The feeding lever fixed to the detecting mechanism will trigger the driving lever on the cocoon supplier only when the size of the yarn becomes thinner than the required denier during reeling operation. Stop motion device. If there is a defect in the reeling, the reel is automatically stopped by brake, which is activated by contact pressure from operation of the detector level. Dropped cocoon gatherers. The operators gathers baskets that have collected all cocoons dropped during end feeding. These are carried to the dropped cocoon separator. These baskets travel intermittently between the cocoon suppliers. Separator of dropped cocoons. The device accurately distinguishes and separates pupae, dropped middle layer cocoons and thick layer dropped cocoons. Semi-automatic reeling machine. This is a mixed mode or hybrid machine between the automatic and multi-end reeling machines. As an application, this type is better for improved reeling efficiency and raw silk quality than the multi-end reeling machine. The semi-automatic reeling machine can be operated with poor quality cocoons, but relies on more labor than the automatic reeling machine. The cooked cocoons are carried into the grouping end pot and the end grouped cocoons are removed to the picking end pot. The correctly picked end cocoons go through the cocoon supplying basket and then to the arranging basin. When the size detector of the reeling thread indicates the feeding motion, the picked end cocoons on standby are fed to the reeling thread by a feeding spoon. The reeling thread passes through the jet about, silk button, first guider, second guider, third guider, fourth guider, size detector, fifth guider and traverse guide, and then it is finally wound on to small reels. The end dropped cocoons are collected by the cocoon buckets and removed to the dropped cocoon basin, where more reelable cocoons are separated and then poured into the grouping end pot. The principal differences between semi-automatic and reeling automatic machine is that the cocoon end grouping, cocoon end picking and cocoon carrying are manual. Cooked cocoons are transferred to the reeling machine manually in buckets. The operator puts a handful of new cocoons as well as dropped cocoons into the brushing pan and switches on the brushing mechanism. The device fitted with paddy straw brushes the cocoon surface in the pan with clockwise and anti-clockwise rotary motion intermittently. After a predetermined number of rotations, the brushes rise above the pan with the filament ends adhering to the paddy straw bristles. The operator collects the filaments, clears them until only a single filament from each cocoon is obtained and then transferred it to the reeling tray. The ends are bound on the binding rod over the tray. The cocoon with filament ends are pushed to the picking gates by the ripples created in the bath. The cocoons are picked up when required and as sensed by the denier sensor. Picking ends. This is a very important function of the reeling operation, which can affect raw silk percentage and reelability. Correct end cocoons should not be permitted in picking ends to minimize cocoon filament waste. Finally, the summary. Automatic reeling machine in India is suitable for biotin cocoon in both yield and efficiency and quality of raw silk, but it is not suitable for multi-voltine cocoons. Moreover, biotin cocoons can also be reeled without losing any yield on multi-end reeling machine, provided they are stifled by hot air method followed by three pan cooking in small flitches. In large units, pressurized cooking system may be followed. For multi-voltine cocoons, the present filleture techniques, that is steam stifling, open pan cooking and reeling on either cottage basin or multi-end basin may be continued. Research findings have also proved that cocoon drying or cooking and reeling technique should be different for biotin and multi-voltin cocoons. Hence, appropriate reeling technique should be adopted depending upon the cocoon quality.